Her relaxed style of campaigning, easy connect with the people, and the resemblance with her grandmother Indira Gandhi always enthused both party workers and the people. Congress has sprung a surprise before the 2019 election by appointing Priyanka Gandhi Vadra as a Congress General Secretary in charge of Eastern Uttar Pradesh. If it is to be believed, demand of Priyanka Gandhi by Congress cadres gathered momentum before an election as there were lingering doubts among the party workers about Rahul Gandhi's ability to lead the party and win an election. Had she taken this plunge earlier, it would have been a virtual admission that Rahul Gandhi had been a failure. She has chosen to make her debut now only after Rahul has settled down in his new job as Congress President and has a firm grip on the party organization. Moreover, the party's recent victories in Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh have improved Rahul Gandhi's confidence level and added to his stature. Priyanka Gandhi is likely to take charge of Eastern Uttar Pradesh on February 4 after a holy dip in the River Ganga at the Kumbh Mela. Priyanka and Rahul Gandhi have zeroed in on February 4 for the holy dip on the occasion of Mauni Amavasya and the second Shahi Snan at the sacred Sangam in Prayagraj. If you look at the map of the biggest and the most politically active state of the Indian Union, you will find that the eastern part of the UP that consists of over 35 Lok Sabha seats is predominantly a BJP stronghold. For Congress leaders, the benchmark remains 2009, when the politically fertile UP gave it 21 seats, its best show in UP after 1984. Of the 21 seats, 13 came from East UP. Of the 7 seats where it stood second, 4 were in the East. Congress' effort will be to revive its traditional core votes, Brahmins, Muslim and Dalits, while it's aware that most of these votes have been lost to the BJP or regional heavyweights. It's counting on its rising political graph to woo them back. The traditional political wisdom is that voting blocs such as Brahmins and Muslim consider the winnability of parties and formation. Therefore, most politically aware Brahmins might shy away from wasting their votes on a struggling Congress. Muslims largely vote for a party capable of defeating the BJP, which most argue is the SP-BSP-RLD alliance. As for Dalits, Mayawati still remain their first choice, with or without the alliance. As all political big-wigs and leaders sincerely believe, Priyanka's entry would surely help the Congress to find roots once again, at least in the UP. But what more? Will she be able to inject enthusiasm in the Congress rank and file all over the nation? She has less than 3 months to organize party workers in a region where the Congress has virtually no presence, no social base and no cadres. A report by Uruj Fatima for NTI Pocket TV.
हमारी वीडियोस को देखने के बाद लाइक और सब्सक्राइब करना बिल्कुल ना भूलें।